Namaskar and good evening to all of you. Happy Teachers' Day.
Thank you, same to you, sir. Same to all of you.
Yeah, thank you so much. The way you knowledge you share, the love you shower has immense power. The teachers, you are really, really awesome. Really, really awesome. And today is a special day for all of us. Not just for the educationalist, for the entire country. It's a special day. Why so? Because among all of us, may not be a teacher, but today is the day when all of us will remember our teachers. Because the teacher profession is a profession continues to be noble, and this profession will continue ever to be noble, undoubtedly. Showering knowledge, sharing knowledge across the humanity, and whatever position one is today is because of our teachers. So this Teachers' Day is not just for teachers, but for entire community in India. Because we remember, but for our teachers, we would not have been what we are today here. So welcome all of you who are now viewing this, the teaser for Amrita Academic Excellence Award 2021. We have, as usual, our special guest, Brahmachari Maheshwara Chaitanyaji. Amongst the midst of his busy schedule, in the process of admissions for Amrita School of Engineering, he has consented to be with us and grace this occasion of inaugurating the Amrita Academic Excellence Award 2021. Welcome, Swamiji, first of all, and our sincere thanks and gratitude to be shown to you for the entire 42, maybe 1 hour's time. For those of you who haven't heard or known Swamiji is a commerce graduate, but then a veteran in the technological front. He completed his master's in MCA, Master's in Computer Application. He is currently the chairman of admissions for Amrita School of Engineering. He is also deputy controller of examinations for Amritapuri campus. And he continues to be the regional director for ICPC, the most sought after programming contest. He has programming and he has conducted many contests under ICPC and has, in fact, brought in a lot of students across our country into this contest of programming. And he was awarded the Best Leadership Award for his participation of over one decade of his valuable service towards ICPC. So congratulations to Swamiji for achieving this marvelous, wonderful award of leadership award. And I'm sure with your participation, with your being in that ICPC, you will win more laurels in the years to come. So thank you, Swamiji. As usual, we have our seeking of blessing from our Chancellor, Mata Amritanandamayi Devi, with whose blessings we are here today as far as Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham is concerned. So, the lamp of knowledge and shower the blessings of Amma through his lighting of his lamp. Over to you, Swamiji.
Thank you.
Yoga Samastha Sugino Bhavantu. It was as mid of 2020 where Swamiji prompted me that we should do some sort of contest for the teachers and honor them with some recognitions. Because when he happened to see those national awardees and CBSE awardees, suddenly it struck his mind, why not we award from Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham? So if at all we are meeting today is the thought, the man whose thought behind all this, which has come into existence, is because of our Swamiji, who prompted this to me as a mid of 2020. He just said, let's work it out. And that is why we shot some mailers to you, we sent some covers to you about Amrita Academic Excellence Award, and there are quite a few teachers and principals who took part from Chennai, Chengalpattu, Trivallur, Kanchipuram. So these were the four districts from where we sought those applications. And all of you remember that we were able to pick up three best principals and three best teachers for Amrita Academic Excellence Award. So it is our pleasure to have those awardees of 2020 with us, right? And with all those pleasing and smiley faces today at 4:30 p.m., completion of their responsibilities as teachers and principals, facing the camera for a change. Otherwise, ma'am, we would have met somewhere in Chennai in the same campus. The scene and scenario would have been totally different. But today we are all looking at one small little lens. Anyway, it's all just because I always believe all these problems and hurdles and difficulties have not to come to stay with us. It'll all pass. It'll all pass and we'll all meet again. I'm confident about it. And let me talk to you with that confidence and go ahead with inaugurating this Amrita Excellence Award 2021. So let me introduce my principal ma'ams and teachers who have won those recognitions, laurels in February 2020 on the 29th. Because the 29th of February will come only again in 2024, the leap year. All right, but then you can still be present. I in fact, on behalf of Swamiji, I invited all the six of them to be present on the 9th January at Wangal. So we have here with us Dr. Priya Sridhar, right, who is the principal of Ramchandra Public School, Chennai. Welcome to you, ma'am, for your presence here. And Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham is thankful to you for your presence here once again. We have Sujata, ma'am, from SKNS PMC Vivekananda Vidyalayam, Perambur. Madam, we are so happy to have you here and pleased to see you sitting in your chair, your school chamber at 4:30 p.m., right? I hope sir will welcome you back with the same smile as much as you're smiling now with us. Don't mention
it. Yeah, always.
All right. So welcome to you, ma'am, and we are indeed thankful to you for your presence here. We have Subbalakshmi, ma'am. Mrs. Subbalakshmi, ma'am, right, from Vidya Mandir, Extantia. Like last time when we met, hubby wasn't well. He met with an accident, and I heard from you this evening that he's quite well, right? And probably when we meet again in January 9th, you must come with him, right? Your better half is always the best half. I'm sure about it. So thank you, ma'am, for your precious time being with us for this teaser of AAEA. And on behalf of Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham, I thank you for your presence again. We have again with us Nitya Saraswati, ma'am, right, ma'am? And I was telling her this evening that I'm daily in touch with her husband. She got a shock of her life. Oh, my God. Okay. So she's from... what's the school name, ma'am? I didn't. Maharishi Vidya Mandir from Kilpak, right? Maharishi Vidya Mandir from Kilpak. And thank you so much, ma'am, being here with us. And I'm sure you are recollecting those sweet memories of 29th of February. I know what is there in your mind. I mentioned to you that you'll have to share your views and pleasantries with us, even if it is critical, no issues. And we have always our ma'am, Krishna Kumari ma'am from the same school where Sujata ma'am represents, that is SKNSPMC Vivekananda Vidyamandir Perambur. Thank you so much, ma'am, for being with us again, right? In fact, all six of you, I'm sorry, Dr. Shankar Narayanan from Sri Gurukulam Public School was not able to join us for some personal reasons. Hopefully he joins us at a later stage. And the reason for all of you to be here is to share your experiences, what you had with us on 29th or prior to 29th, maybe about 5 to 6 minutes. Before that, nothing begins, nothing commences, nothing starts without the address of Swamiji Brahmachari Maheshri Chaitanya. He's too much engrossed into the admission process, I know. In fact, I had to pull him out and say, Swamiji, all our teachers and principals are here. He said, okay, fine. So Swamiji, I understand the pressure that you're going through, right? So, but still, your presence here makes this lot of blessings for us. So over to you, Swamiji, for officially inaugurating the teaser of Amrita Excellence, Academic Excellence Award 2021. Over to you, Swamiji, for your few words of inaugurational address.
Thank you, Chris. A very warm good evening to all of you. Basically, I feel that much more than the pressure I have from the admission process, I believe that the teachers who are sitting in front of me will have perhaps pressures from different sides, because they have to look up the family, they have to look up the classes, they have to learn, yes. They have to teach, there's pressure from the school. So from all the sides, I am 100% sure that you are facing much more pressure than me. So thanks for joining us for the second edition of the Amrita Academic Excellence Awards. I believe that we this is the right time to introduce such a kind of award. Myself and Krish, we used to discuss about this on how to launch and when to launch. We started discussion perhaps a couple of months back, because see, we all see that much more than any community, the teaching community have affected a lot. The entire teaching learning process has shifted and it has come to a different level where teachers are now learners.
Yes.
Earlier it was not that much, but now it is 100% or at least 99% they are learners. And we as teachers are forced to be with the technology. And what my understanding is, even the new education policy, it is also about to take place or get implemented in next couple of years. So this shall be an opportunity, or we have to embrace this opportunity to accept the fact that the new education policy or the change that will bring in when the new education policy is implemented, and what we are doing now or what the teachers are doing now, currently there is a major shift going on. So when both the things merge, what will happen? So this is the right time where we start accepting the fact that we have to change. And basically this award ceremony or the announcement of the awards, we wanted to encourage, we wanted to recognize, we wanted to give a kind of recognition for the student, the teachers, to make sure that they are well accepted in the society. Because the future generation is in the hands of teachers. And it is quite understanding, it is quite natural that teachers needs to be uplifted. So that is why we keep on engaging teachers. We keep on bringing new and new experiences in teachers' life, because we never wanted to stop this online webinars or what we call online sessions for the teachers, for the principals, for the counselors. So this will continue and this has to continue. And once your mind is engaged in learning, and once you have somebody to support you, once there is an inspiration in front of you, then struggle will never be there in life. So that is what all we see. So currently that is what is happening. So let me officially inaugurate this session. Let me officially inaugurate this award ceremony or this project or this venture, noble venture, where we will start finding out the best performers. We will start finding out the best teachers, best schools across the state, perhaps across the country, moving forward across the country. And let me take this opportunity to officially inaugurate this entire event, this entire session, or again the Amrita Academy Excellence Awards. Thank you, Krish.
Thank you, Swamiji, for a wonderful inaugural address, and I'm sure it will go a long way in recognizing many more teachers. As you rightly mentioned, that this is the time where we could do something totally different. And as Swamiji rightly mentioned, that how do we engage teachers? And let me also mention that during the pandemic, during the lockdown, the teachers have certainly done not just a wonderful job, a job which nobody ever imagined. Today they have become tech savvy, and they will teach you on many platforms. You know, they will talk about webinars can be conducted this way, that way, this way, this way. Because I know when I interact with teachers on this particular MS Teams, they say, "Oh,
so we have an inspiration. We have an inspiration now coming up, Vasanthi ma'am."
Oh, wow! We have more than inspiration. Welcome to you, ma'am, and you know. I call ma'am as Akka, and Akka said by 5:15, look at that. She, in fact, left her school Teachers Day and then come back to us. So welcome back, ma'am. This is an event where we are actually inaugurating the 2021 Amrita Excellence Academic Excellence Award 2021. And I would like to have your blessings on those teachers and principals who have been the awardees for 2020. It was inaugurated by just now about 5 minutes back by Swamiji. And now, since you are here, and we are indeed not happy and delighted, we are honored by your presence well in advance. And now may I request Akka to just, because Akka's, if you go through Akka's profile, madam has, I mean, you can just run through that award, this award, this award, that award, that award, this award. So you have won so many laurels in your career in the field of education, and I know I'm sure that many more will keep falling on to you. And in 2020, Akka couldn't make it that particular day because of her commitment for some training with the CBSE people, and she was one of those awardees as the best educationalist. You met both of them, like from Mahatma School, right, and from SSVM. So Akka couldn't make it, and I'm sure every one of us heard about Akka. In fact, not just Tamil Nadu, across the country, ma'am is known for her, you know, personality. For her personality, you can define what the personality is all about after hearing her on the NEP, which will come up after we close this. So Akka, I won't take your time. Can you just bless this the entire group, the viewers of the future, who are going to be the part of those Amrita Academic Excellence Award 2021, and those five teachers who are in our presence because Teachers Day. Let's have your blessings on all the teachers who are present here with us. Over to you, Akka. Let's begin with your blessings. Ma'am, you are muted, Akka. Akka, you are muted.
Oh, I think my voice is audible.
Now audible, ma'am. Yeah, you're audible.
So there is a repetition, I think, Krishna, for all your talk. Either the YouTube link or Facebook link is repeating, I don't know. I seem to be getting a repetition.
No, you are, as far as we are concerned, you are quite clear, ma'am.
Fine. First of all, thank you for the great opportunity.
Can others mute? Yeah.
First of all, thank you so much for this wonderful opportunity provided. I found that this occasion of teachers' day is the most apt occasion to honor teachers. Thank you. So what do you want to add? It's an echo. Why my voice is getting quite super over and over again.
Yeah, yeah.
And excuse me, ma'am, there is a web app kept opened, ma'am. Google Chrome web app is kept
so.
Open.
That's why
yeah,
the
yes, ma'am.
Voice over.
Yeah, you have the web.
Or something yeah. has to happen. Not
no,
sure.
No problem. Take your time. All this technology, we are just. Yeah, I think you can close that. Then your sound won't be.
Yes, I think so.
Disturbed.
Fine. So once again. Yeah, otherwise is it echo and my voice is getting repeated over and over again. Now it seems to be better. Mm-hmm. Can you do something about it so that this overlap? Otherwise, I'm listening to my voice.
Yeah, I think you have opened one more app and kept it, ma'am. That's why I think two apps are working. You can off one app. You too.
Let me take a look.
Yeah. Take your time, ma'am. No issues.
Just a minute. I don't know whether.
Yeah,
too many windows. Yeah, it seems to be better.
Take your time.
Okay. So this is helping. Is this fine now?
Now it looks fine.
Okay. Yeah. As of now, I don't hear the echo good enough. So first of all, once again, a very warm evening to one and all present here. I want to thank my brother Rishitambi for pulling me over here. Thank you so much. On the occasion of Teachers' Day, no, I think again there's that echo. I don't know where I'm stuck. Let me see.
Somewhere you're stuck.
I'll have to come out of one meeting, I think.
Are you cannot have two meetings? All right, so what we will do is, ma'am, Priya, ma'am, you're only seen half the way. Half, yeah. All right, your camera can be brought down, yeah. Akka, you have come out of it? Now it's okay. Akka will take some time. Akka, I think you're muted. Akka, you are muted. Akka, you are muted.
Yes, I think so. Yes, I close everything. It's just one window open now, thank God.
Yeah, wonderful. So, now it's more clear.
I know on this wonderful occasion of teachers. Oh, I'm speaking a mic is on. I'm very clear. Please check it out. My mic is on. I think I'm clear.
Yeah, your mic is on. Your mic is on.
Yes. So what we are all looking at is on this occasion of Teachers' Day.
Some disturbance somewhere.
So again, there's this echo happening and maybe another window troubling me.
So what? We'll wait.
I don't know. Again, there's an echo and a repetition.
Madam, what could be the reason?
Your technical person to close my other windows and just get me into one. You know.
Ma'am, could you please attend my call, ma'am? I'm just calling you over the phone.
Yeah, I can get that. I'm just wondering, you're holding up everybody here.
No issues.
Tell me, Janani.
All this happens. It's all learning.
Yeah, let me try again with a lot of help from Janani. Okay. Hopefully,
now it is clear.
Yes. Thank God, Krish. No, no more of it. Right. So, beginning with this wonderful day of the Guru being honored, I think probably our country is the only one where the focus is given to the Guru, the remover of ignorance. So, when we had this function in my school, from where I went into one forum and jumped into this one now, we had called a lot of our old students to talk about their journey, because I think that matters a lot. And we were very happy to note that almost a student who studied about 20 years ago told me that whatever we had taken them through 20 years back has relevance today in terms of their collaborative skills, their communication skills, and the emphasis that the school had given to the core scholastics even in those days, without that force and thrust on academics and results. And that seemed to have made our day as teachers. When our children, who are now well settled in their world of work, come back and tell us that this is what the school has made, that is the moment for the teacher. So on this occasion of Teachers' Day, we can dedicate ourselves once again, I think, as teachers to the cause of our children. Because we always believe that without the Shishya, there is no Guru. The Shishya has to be there, otherwise to whom will the Guru teach? To whom will the Guru mold? We need know all that. So we could be akin to the gardener who's got a lovely garden to tend to, delicate children who are going to flower into beautiful human beings. We remove the weeds for them, which could be painful. You could be the potter, right, making the children the clay. All the analogies are fine. The bottom line is, when our wonderful children go out and into the world of work, that's where the real calling comes. So most of our children have kind of reiterated, it's not the results. Nothing matters except the grooming for life. And one of my students who spoke today, incidentally studying in the Amrita Vidyalayam at Coimbatore, doing his engineering, Karthik Ashok. So he's doing his third year and he was going into the fourth, and so proudly mentioned that Amrita is the ideal home for him because it's an extension of Shishya.
Oh, wow.
So the same culture, the same safety, the same emotional support, it's happening. And that is equally important for our children, not to jump into a new culture. So our children feel really good coming out of Shishya, going into another place which takes care of Shishya as well. So that's the note I'd like to talk about. And I think you did have the honoring of the teachers. You were planning to call them over. Is that done, or are we going to go ahead with that?
No, we will do that shortly.
Fine.
I mean, the honoring, these are all honored teachers of Zero. The honoring, anyway, 9th of January, Akka, you'll have to keep yourself free for that. January 9th.
Oh,
no CBSE training, right? It'll be only training for the tummy, not at all for CBSE. So keep aside the 9th January. All right. So let's go on to our business now. Thanks a lot again for everyone who are viewing now. And let's see a teaser video with no sound. I'm sorry, I'm not able to play the sound, but let's have a look at this. What happened in 2020? Over to the video, please. I'm sorry, no video, but still. So this was just inaugurated by Swamiji now. So these are the last 2020 awardees. Are currently present here with us. Thanks once again. So this is Manimegle ma'am from SSBM, and we have the chief guest as the Home Secretary of Tamil Nadu government, Dr. Niranjan Madi. We had regional officer Mr. Srinivasan, who graced the occasion in the evening. Sujata ma'am received the award. This is an IAS Home Secretary, Dr. Niranjan Madi. So this was the function, some photographs, flashbacks to those awardees of 2020, as well as for those future awardees of 2021. You can recognize this gentleman, right?
Oh yes, of course.
and this is our
colleagues who are there receiving their awards.
These are the stretch of awardees. All right, so this is our director of the campus, Chennai campus, from Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham. This is Srinivasan sir addressing the gathering in the evening. And this is Mr. Radhakrishnan from Air India, who was also present as a guest.
Wonderful.
So, you know Sujata ma'am? Okay, this is Swamiji welcoming Mani Meghale ma'am.
Yeah.
We missed you, Akka, that day. We missed you badly.
This is Hamsapriya.
Hamsapriya ma'am from Mahatma School from Madurai.
It's all known to me personally.
He is from Vivekananda Trust, Vivekananda Kendra Trust.
Narayan also known, very nice person.
Very, very nicely. He was supposed to be here, but then he couldn't.
Okay.
So this is, again, his family receiving it from Dr. Niranjan Madi from the IAS. He is now retired as a Home Secretary. So ma'am, you remember this face? All right. So, who is this? Oh, Sujata ma'am receiving the award from. Congratulations, Sujata ma'am.
Thank you, sir.
All right, ma'am.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
So, the old flashbacks for you. So, I'm sorry, I'm not able to play the audio, but there was a beautiful audio which is not coming through now. It doesn't really matter. As long as seeing is believing.
Definitely.
I think I made some fun of you, right? So here, some humor I brought in here. Krishna Kumari ma'am, some humor?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Dr. Shankar from Amrita School of Engineering, Bengal. He was awarded, national awardee from Pondicherry, Puducherry last year.
Wow.
He addressed so well as to how he managed to get that. So this is the group, and finally I get off from this particular teaser. So, Akka, thanks for being with us here and, blessing all the teachers. Now, Akka, you can hear from those awardees of last year, that's 2020, February 29. Whoever wants to take on some few experiences, and then I go for 2021 presentation. And then at 5:15, we assemble for Vasanthi ma'am's NEP, right? Everything that you want to know.
That's the bewildering part of the question now.
Absolutely. I'm going to ask some questions to ma'am and she's going to answer all our doubts. So, Sujata ma'am, you want to take the lead or who wants to take it? Sujata ma'am, your experience is about 3 minutes to 4 minutes. Over to you, ma'am.
Namaste and my humble pranam to Swamiji and also all the dignitaries present here. And it is really a very good occasion today we all have gathered here. Wishing all the entire the teaching community a happy Teachers Day and a happy Guru Purnima. And this is a day we have to salute the entire teaching fraternity for their hard work, dedication and the commitment in addition to the teaching their subject in their classrooms. And the teachers are the exceptional guides and mentors who play a prominent role in the lives of their students. So I have to share this experience because as a teacher, we have been recognized by getting an awards from different organization. And the special award I have to mention about the Amrita. And this we couldn't forget in our life. It was really very happy. We cannot say that it registered in our mind. And the thing is, they came and gave the form and like ordinary thing, we thought that we will be filling up all the things, but the way they have asked and they have selected based on their work commitment and how the school recognized what the service being rendered by the school, service being rendered by the teachers. So they are not seeing only the teachers who are producing only the 10% result. I've seen they have got so many parameters to see that whether the teacher is being awarded, if they have been really doing a wonderful service. So we have seen the teachers being based on their, when he asked about us, Krishnakutty sir itself came to our school and he also came with Janani ma'am and we are really happy how they are all just having a cordial relationship with a different organization and they are also doing a lot of career guidance programs and motivational talk to these students. So our students were also benefited. So many children also from our school has been joined in the Amrita University and they are also getting a lot of exposure. Last year, plus two students, they have gone there. And during this awards, we have filled and the parameters when we are asking about it, so many people have applied, and in that few have been selected is based on their academic excellence as well as the teacher-students relationship. We are not taking students as just as a students. We always think students as their own children. We say, no, the teachers are the second parents. So it's really, we mean it, and the teachers, they adopt the children wherever necessary, and even if they are not, couldn't pay the fees, the teachers stepping, and we also go to their houses and a home visit and all doing the service to the nearby areas like a government school where we are making the children to have a free tuition. We are calling them to our school, and some teachers nearby house, they are also doing a wonderful service. And really, I can say that after being a teacher, a teacher is recognized only because of their some awards or some appreciation when we are getting it from the other people. So when we have been selected as a awardee, we feel very happy that when our work has been recognized properly. And today is the day I couldn't open up my WhatsApp because the students, as ma'am has said, the older students, they were saying it, you touched our heart, ma'am, that you have made us to reach this position. Now we are, it is because of your love and affection. Generally, they will say physics teacher means very rough and tough. They won't talk to the students like that. But they were commenting, you are different. You are just, I like to, because when I was studying, I was having a feeling physics is a dry subject and the children also feel. So I took up the subject and I want to do something different by creating with that is activity oriented teaching and make them to create interest. And because of me, many students have taken up the physics subject. So I feel proud. And the students also, not only after they have left us, they have reached the different position and they are joining us in the alumni meeting. And today all the teachers of our institution were getting messages wishing us for a happy life and all. So it's all because of the students we have been recognized. And Amrita there in that function, really my eyes filled with the tears because of their hospitality, their love and the affection from the day, that is the 2 days before they gave the invitation. From the invitation when we reached there, they were just giving a very good hospitality. And also the like a brotherhood, Krishnan sir, I couldn't forget because he hold my father's name, Krishnan Kutty, and I always have a great regard. And just like that, for giving an award and leaving it, it was not like that. They were taking us personally. And really, the next year, I wish all the teachers who can apply and your hard work will be greatly recognized by the Amrita University. And we all need blessings from the elderly people and also from Swamiji. And thank you for giving this opportunity. It was really an excellent this day. Actually, I can say that it was like a blessings we get from my parents and God. That was Amma University is there. So I was personally touched when I got the award, that too from regional officer. And thank you for giving that opportunity. And it's all I have to thank personally the Krishnan Kutty sir for giving me this opportunity. I've been a part in getting the prizes. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Sujata ma'am.
Yeah.
I know Krishnan Kutty is a very frightening name for you. Yeah, I know, you know how much of beatings you would have got from your dad. I can just visualize that. But
Krishnan Kutty will never beat. Krishnan Kutty will show lot of love towards the children.
I know. I was just pulling your leg, Sujata ma'am. So anyway, thank you for a wonderful experience on how it all went around. Now, anybody else among the balance, I mean, four of you can take this lead. Who wants to take the lead can go ahead with the lead. No issues at all. Over to you. Anybody? Priya ma'am, you want to try?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Respected dignitaries of Amrita College of Engineering, principals and teachers of various institutions, a very good evening to one and all. I really feel privileged to address in this virtual ceremony on this occasion of Teachers' Day. And I felt gracefully blessed and honored as one of the best principal award and as a platinum awardee. And why I felt really blessed in the sense, like amidst so many experienced principals, I hold nearly 5 to 6 years experience as an administrator, but hardly and 20 plus years experience as a teacher. So that made me to feel very proud among the dignitaries, and just 45, 46 years old, and I was overwhelmed when I received the Platinum Awardee. And when Krishnan Kutty sir and Janani ma'am visited the school, the entire, I mean, management, teachers, everyone were overwhelmed, and they were speechless. And within a week, the school management honored me for and recognized me for this award. Really, still a memorable day and add on in my profile. I was excited and thrilled to receive this prestigious award, that too from CBSE regional officer Srinivasan sir on 29th February. A day which where I can never forget in my life. Thank you, sir, wholeheartedly. Thank you. And I feel really blessed among so many senior principals and teachers. I am one and part of this virtual ceremony. And to be very open, I am really in touch with the Krishnan Kutty sir and Janani madam every day, and really their attitude and way they share all their, I mean, the knowledge, and then the webinar session, whatever they conduct. So all the programs are attended by the teachers, by my school teachers also. They really feel very happy and lot of continuous learning in this pandemic period. Thank you, sir. A heartfelt thanks, sir. Thank you.
Thank you so much for your lovely, encouraging feedback on the 2020 AAEA map. Keep it up. Thanks for saying many times thanks to Krishnan Kutty. Very happy about it. All right. Keep saying that. Just joking. Who wants to take on now?
Can I?
Yeah, please, ma'am. The floor is for you all. Please go ahead.
Thank you. Wishing all of you a happy Teachers' Day. And all the teachers all around the globe, thank you very much. Today I called up my principal. I left school in the year 1983. And I called up my principal in Bombay, but he's not keeping well. So his wife spoke to me and I had to tell her that every year I wish him. So he calls me up and he says, "You remember me?" He asks me, and then we have a small conversation, but this year he couldn't speak to us. But even then, I conveyed my wishes to him. Today morning, the phone was flooded with so many messages coming from, I did not know from where they still remembered us and got our phone numbers and all that. And then they kept wishing us that Amrita Award, which I received, overwhelming experience it was. Really, I'm telling you, when Krishnan Kutty sir called me in the morning, I was in class. So there were two, missed calls. So I called back and suddenly he said, "You're shortlisted for the award." I couldn't believe my ears actually, because after Amrita Award, it was actually, I think, past 1 month. It was after 1 month, I think, he called us up. Then again, I just sat down. I kept my phone down and I sat down. I was wondering, really, did I get an award? And then I called up my principal and I told her, "Wow." She said, "Wow, you're really selected." Actually, because it was a very short period. The day we had a teachers meeting in school, and the principal was actually literally firing everybody for something that happened in school. Towards the end of her speech, what happened? She says, "Sivalakshmi, come to my room." So I was wondering what happened, why did she call me, and whether that firing is going to extend, I thought. Then when I went to her room, she's telling me, "You're taking part in this competition." Oh my God, I was very happy. And then she said, I said, "Ma'am, give me some 3-4 days. She said, "Nothing doing. Another 2 days, you're giving me your applications and this is your questionnaire. Fill it and give it to me." So then I said, "Okay, fine." And I filled it and I gave it to her. Because I didn't know that the rest of them had already given it to her. And I was actually late, the last one to have given questionnaire. And I filled it and I gave it to her with all whatever I had done, innovations and all that I had done. I gave it to her. And then when I got this news from Krishnan Kutty sir, no, I was totally surprised. And then the day he was coming to give the letter, invitation, that day, the principal was very busy with the accreditation. And Krishnan Kutty sir, we were having hide and seek at that day because I couldn't call him to school because they were busy. I said, "Sir, can you come some other day?" But even then he said, "No, I'm passing that side. I'll give it to your principal and go." Then he gave it to the principal and he went. And then that the remaining story I told you there, when my husband met with an accident on that day evening, he had an accident and all that. And so after that, when I came back to school with the award, with whatever you all had given me, no, my vice principal, she held it in her hand and she saying, jackpot adichittu pola irukku ungalku engalukella idhu maari award kadaikave illaye. And then principal took it and she said, I'm going to give it in front of all the children. So then the first thing I told the children, I am because you are. Because of all of you, I am a teacher today. And it is all because of you that I have got this award. Thanks to all of you. My primary was totally around me. Everybody started hugging me and kissing me, and such love we got from all the children. They were totally happy that day. It, like as if it was their award and they have received that award. And then after that, I went on telling everybody my experience around. It was totally overwhelming. So that day, I just wanted to tell you, Krishnakuti sir, I just wanted to tell you, but because of this, my husband's problem and all, I couldn't say something. When Amma, the first time in the newspaper, when she was a small kid, when the first news about her reciting hymns about Krishna and all that, it had come in the newspapers in Bombay. I remember my daddy speaking about it to my uncle, my peripa. He was telling her there is one small girl who is reciting Krishna hymns and all that. I still have a small faint remembrance of her, seeing her in the newspaper, and I didn't expect that so many years after that I will be receiving an award from her. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you, all of you. This program is actually a stress buster. Okay. For all of us. Thank you, sir. Thank
Subbulash,
you.
Subbulashmi, ma'am, I think, you know, last time also, I mean, in the sense, you spoke very well. Today also spoke very well, and it's a fantastic feel start hearing about the good things that Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham has been doing to the field of education, and you are the backbone to all of us for whatever we are doing today. So thanks a lot, ma'am, for wonderful talk on your experiences about the Academic Excellence Award 2020. Now, two of my teachers are left. Anybody can pick up, right? Who?
Shall I start?
Anywhere, any time. The floor is all yours. Both together also, you can talk. No issues.
My humble pranams to Guiding Light Amritananda Mai Mataji, Sri Maheshwara Chaitanya Ji, Chairman Amrita Vishwapeetham, Professor Sri Mithil Krish Ji, Chairman, my guiding star Srimati K. Sujata Ma'am, Principal of SKNS PMC Vivekananda Vidyalaya Junior College Perambur, and all the educationists and the galaxy of intellectuals, a very happy evening and greetings from my side. I am honored to receive Amrita Academic Excellence Award 2020 for Teachers Gold Award on 29 February 2020 from Amrita School of Engineering, Chennai campus. This day is a red letter day in my life. I can never forget this day. I still remember, as madam said, when sir called, I was in class, and I went and told my ma'am, we are shortlisted. Congratulations. My happiness knew no bounds. I felt as though I was in paradise. Okay, the day when I was awarded also, the serene atmosphere, the entire campus, everything stole my heart. And tears were rolling down in my eyes, my plumpy cheeks. Sir was behind my back commenting and criticizing. Come on, tell about me, tell about me, tell about me. Slowly my mind. It was an awesome moment. Then coming back to, I would like to express my sincere thanks and appreciation to Professor Mithil Krish Ji and Swami Ji and my charismatic leader, Srimati K. Sujata Ma'am. Sri Krishnan Krishji Ji, it was a most welcome surprise at a very important time in my career. I had no idea that you were considering me for the award. So it came as a complete pleasant surprise to me. Hence, I express my sincere gratitude to your good self, who is a man of simple living and high thinking. I bow my head to you, sir.
No, not to me.
My special thanks to Srimati K. Sujata Ma'am, the principal of our Vidyalaya, who has served a role model to me. My enormous gratitude to you, ma'am, for having recognized my worthy and efficiency. Thank you, ma'am. And very big thanks to Vivekananda Education Society and Sri Veerasamy sir, who had selected me in 1993. considering my caliber, and Urma ma'am, who is no more, I extend my thanks to both of them, and extend my thanks to my department people and my fellow teachers for having supported me in all my endeavors. I once again thank each and every one of you. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much. You know, with such a emotional talk of yours, and you remember all those moments. In fact, I was standing behind you in the mic and say, come on, I was just trying to pull your legs. Anyway, thanks a lot for the memories that you have. And Akka, where are you? Are you there?
Sir, she'll be joining.
Right. So let's have ma'am. Ma'am? Yes. Where are you? Yeah, you can talk now. The last teacher who's left now, the fifth teacher.
Yeah, you can continue
now.
First of all, I would like to thank everyone, those who gave an opportunity to talk before people like you. Yes, and happy Teachers Day to everyone present here, first of all. I am a teacher from Magadishi Vidya Mandir, Chetpad. Okay, first of all, I would like to thank my dean and director, Mr. Namachivayam, who he passed away last month only. It was a very shock news for me. Selected me as a one of the teacher among these for this award. Actually, we four teachers were applied for this one. Okay, when my principal sir was called me and he gave me this application, there are some many categories was there. Yeah, innovative methods of teaching. What are all the posts you had? So it was very difficult for me to fill it up. But I was so shocked to get that award also. I am very, 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 very happy to get the award. Okay, we used to do meditation on Thursday, every Thursday. Ours is a meditation school. One Thursday when I was doing meditation, I got a call from Krishnan Kutty sir. I was so happy, I couldn't able to believe my ears also, whether it's true or not, because four of the teachers from secondary wing, one teacher, primary wing one teacher, middle school wing one teacher, high school wing one teacher was applied for that one. I am from middle school. I was the only person selected for that. So I went to my principal and I told. He was also very happy. No problem. He will come and meet you. You will be getting the award. Like that he said. I was so much happy to express my gratitude here. I should not say that it's a thank. I should not say thanks to anyone, because I have to show my gratitude. Because I would like to highlight a proverb. That is, thankfulness is the beginning of gratitude, and gratitude is the completion of thankfulness. Okay, this is the word given by Charles. Okay, so thankfulness is the words given by words, but completion, gratitude is the only thing will be done by action. So definitely, one more thing, the way to develop a person's attitude is only by giving some appreciation and encouragement. So also, this is applicable for our students also. We used to appreciate children, definitely they will come out with a lot of good things. The same thing was done by Krishnan Kutty sir to our thing also, not sir, Vishwa Vidya Peetham. So I am so much thankful to them. The way they have greeted on the day, it was like we people were like princes, we the teachers, and it was like a what to say, it was like a great thing. Okay, we were warm welcome was given by everyone. We were so happy. So, but the teachers, those who are going to apply for the upcoming year, they have to work hard. Yes. So it's a lesson for others also. You have to make so many things. You have to work out very well. Yes, you can get the appreciation from the dignitaries, definitely. Thanks a lot, sir. Thanks for giving me an opportunity to talk before you all. Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. And we have one more person in the car, Dr. Shankar Narayan, sir. Vanakkam. Vanakkam Vandanam Susagadam. My Akka is firing me. Why did you not call Shankar Narayan? I said, no, sir. Sorry, he's traveling. So you're able to hear us. Are you able to talk some one or two sentences? In the car, it'll be difficult. You're using your laptop. Anyway, welcome to you, sir. Welcome to you.
How are you?
I'm okay. Welcome to you, sir. And Dr. Shankar Narayan, sir, was one of those recipients of Amrita Academy Excellence Award 2020, right? So congratulations to you. When you travel, it won't be clear. So I won't allow you to talk. Maybe last, I'll make you talk, right? Okay. So I will just go through a few slides of mine and then take on to Akka. Just few slides I wish to show you. Right. So this is the award for next year, that is Amrita Academic Excellence Award 2021. And of course, as I mentioned to you, all what we are today is the blessings of Amma. And this is headquarters of Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham, Coimbatore. Yes, Amrita has been ranked number one, right, by the Higher Education Times Higher Education ranking. And as far as NIRF is concerned, National Institutional Ranking Framework, we are the fourth best university in India. All this has happened during the pandemic times. In fact, Times Higher Education came about 2 months back. This came about 1 month back. And the reason one is we are the fourth best university in terms of, you know, innovation. So these three awards which we received in the last 2 months. So congratulations to all the Vishwavidyapeetham and thanks to all those teachers and well-wishers, faculties, alumni, students for making Amrita the number one best university and the number fourth best university as far as the NIF ranking is concerned. So the next slide which I would like to show you is we have about six campuses. We will not take much time. So happy Teachers Day, as everyone was talking about. This is my teacher whom I can never forget in my life, but for her, her name is Mrs. Susan Chacko, right? Why I cannot forget about her is because I'm alive today because of her, because so many reasons. Because in 8th standard, she was my class teacher. I studied in Kendriya Vidyalaya at Avadi in as early as 1975, I passed out. I was not good in speaking English because I was brought in from Kerala speaking school from Palakkad to a English medium school, Kendriya Vidyalaya, and I was totally fish out of water, and I decided that I cannot continue the school. I wanted to commit suicide. I went and spoke to this teacher, Mrs. Susan Chacko. She said, shut up, continue, let people laugh at you, speak as much as you can. And she gave me a commitment in the year 1970 that let people laugh at you because you're speaking in English. It doesn't really matter. And continue to speak. And she made a mention that a day will come into your life that you will just not be able to speak English alone, but you will be able to take classes for teachers, principals, and students. So her commitment in 1970 came back to me as a dream which came true. So I salute this teacher whenever I do my presentation. So thanks a lot, Mrs. Susan Chacko, for my being present today. And let me keep on going a little faster on this. So, you know, when the COVID struck us, Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham, you know, taking clues from each of you, conducting classes online, we felt we also must do something. So we had something to do with Big Talk. We had something to do with Let Us Hear My School. We had On Labs. We had Coffee with Krish. We had Every Parent Must Know. We had Gana Amritam. We are conducting a music competition. We have Amrita Listens, right? And we had Margadashis. So we had, in fact, these are maybe close to 65 events in the last 2 months. I think this is what I wanted to share. This is a big topic. We had varieties of people coming and talking on different subjects. We have something to do with Let's Hear My School, right? We had invited many school principals across the country. They talk on their experiences as far as their control of the schools during the COVID. We had Coffee with Krish, and this was more into inviting people within our own institutions. This is what is happening on every Sunday. We invite teachers to sing songs, not the music teachers, other than music teachers. It's a lovely program which is happening for the last 6 weeks or so. We also have Amrita OLabs. So far, we have oriented more than 10,000 teachers in the last 2 weeks. We had done about 13 such programs across the country. So thanks to teachers, this is something which is hitting like a wildfire. Help experiments in physics, chemistry, mathematics, and biology, as well as a bit of English through online labs. So this is a real hit. And yesterday we had a discussion with the CBSE chairman as to how we should go about and how we could include this in the curriculum for the future. So OLab is certainly, which is catching up like a wildfire. So Every Parent Must Know, that is my favorite episode, which I run it every week. And Amrita Listens is for those students who had applied to Amrita School of Engineering in Chennai, Ettimadai, Amartapuri, and Bangalore. So This is the AAA process, that the submission of applications through online. We'll send you all these details a little later, because Akka is waiting for her presentation, which is more worth than me talking about AAEA. These are announcing of results. All this will come to you a little later. So the last date for registration is 10th October. For Tamil Nadu teachers, it is totally different compared to the other teachers across the country. Just to brief you on this, the finale is on the 9th January. I invite all my teachers who are present here for this particular function. And this will be hopefully conducted at our Wengal campus, Amardha School of Engineering at Wengal, Thiruvallur district, close to Chennai. So 9th January is the D-Day for us. So teachers, 5 years of experience and 10 years of experience as a teacher for the principals. Documents, of course, there must be a graduate or a postgraduate, certificates, awards, so far received, co-curricular activities, extracurricular activities. And whatever possible, we are not being so stringent and strict on this because of the current situation. And Tamil Nadu, it goes like this. We have 6 zones, Coimbatore, Salem, Madurai, Trichy, Pondicherry, Chennai. 10th October is the submission application. District level results announcement by 10th November. Zonal meet, we'll have a zonal meet. We'll have one in Coimbatore, we have one in Salem, we have one in Madurai. Those dates have given. And all this will come as the finalists will come on the 9th January to Amardha School of Engineering, Chennai. Now, for Tamil Nadu, it's simple. All the 6 zones, we have each zone will be attached with one particular district. For example, Dindigul will be attached to Madurai, Theni will be attached to Madurai, Tirunelveli will be attached to Madurai, Tuticorin attached to Madurai. So we will pick up 2 teachers and 2 teachers from CBSE matriculation, bring them, like means about 38 districts plus Pondicherry, 39 into 4 teachers, 156 teachers will receive an award from us, maybe a gift worth ... We'll announce that a little later through our mails and this. And from that, zonal award is, out of that 156, each zone will come up with 2 teachers of CBSE, 2 teachers of matriculation, and those 4 teachers will go up to the finals. And out of them, out of the 12 we have, 3 will be selected as the final for the 9th, for principals, I'm sorry, for the final on the 9th. All these details we'll explain and elaborate when we get in touch later. Similar for all the teachers also for the Tamil Nadu state, like each district, instead of 2, 2, 2, 2, we'll have all 4 teachers from each districts, 2 from matriculation, 2 from CBSE, bring them up to the zone 1, will come up, then from there we'll go to the 2nd level and they will all reach for the final level. So ultimately we'll find 3 principals, right, from CBSE, 3 principals from matriculation reaching up on the top, and you'll also find 3 teachers from CBSE and 3 teachers from matriculation reaching the top. So we'll have 12 teachers appearing for the finale of our show on the 9th January 2021. I don't have time to explain in detail, but I'm sorry for I made some mistake for one time, but then I can elaborate it a little later when we meet again or through mails or whatever source of communication. So this is the number you need to contact, or you can write to them, right? Write to this particular mail on whatever clarification that you need, 93450-76625. And we have a similar teachers and principals across the country. Other than Tamil Nadu, this is Tamil Nadu separately, zone-wise. Across the country, we have had registration expected. And we will pick up some 50 teachers and 25 principals across the country other than Tamil Nadu, and then bring those 3 plus 3 principals and 3 teachers among those who are applying. So we'll have Tamil Nadu separately and for the other separately. So this is what it is in a nutshell. We will send you a detailed report or detailed invitation through mail or through even by post, we'll send it across to you. So I don't have time to further talk. If anybody wants to contact me, you can also contact me in this particular number, 96775073900. I'm sorry, I'm rushing because one of time, and now we have a very important discussions on the national educational policy. So Akka, where are you? And I'm not taking much of your time. I think Akka is ready with all this. Akka, can we take over before we get on to this? Shall we?
Sure.
Go ahead, Akka.
Yes, I'm ready. And first of all,
already,
wonderful presentation and congratulations to all the awardees. You know, each one when they spoke, it took me through their journey of a committed, caring teacher, you know. And I think that is the most gratifying experience a teacher can ever have. And to have somebody recognize that job, you know, that is most important, because there are so many, many teachers, thousands of them, who are so dedicated and who go unrecognized. But I think when you award teachers through this process, even the national awards and other CBSE awards, all this will also happen similarly. But then when every teacher at her level, with whatever little experience the teacher has got, she's trying to get it at her school level or zonal level, and then being recognized by an organization like Amrita, I think it's a great thing that you are doing. Great service to the, you know, to the entire, all of us as teachers are truly grateful for that, because recognition is very important. And it doesn't matter from whom it comes. A teacher's award is a teacher's award. And to us, this is the best award ever. And like you said, the reward, as many of them spoke, the reward is actually different from the award. The reward is when the children send us their messages, tell us that whatever I am is because of you. And, you know, we had one member here saying, I called my teacher up today to speak. I do this every year. That is a reward for that teacher. Not the money or the, nothing matters to the teacher finally. The child matters. And it makes our day. So you should be congratulated from the Amrita University and your team, Krish and team, for the wonderful recognition you're giving to teachers. It makes the day for us. Thank you.
Thank you so very much. I'm sure after my presentation of the slides, most of the teachers who are present here would have been confused. I don't mind you getting confused. You can get back to the number which I mentioned here. You can also write to me. Your confusion can be sorted out, because I was a little rushing up for one of time. But then we have with us our special guest, right, Dr. Vasanthi Thiagarajan. And to brief about ma'am, I need to run through her profile a bit, otherwise there are so many teachers from North, East and West. Also, I would like them to know who is Dr. So Dr. Vasanthi Thiagarajan, who left no stones unturned in the field of education, has completed her MA Economics and her PhD in Education at Harvard University, USA, and received certificate in Journalism, a certificate in Differentiated Instructional Strategies from WIDE, Harvard University, USA. Is also received by Dr. Vasanthi Thiagarajan. And Dr. Vasanthi Thiagarajan has attended a program on Project Zero on Multiple Intelligence Theory in Practice with Dr. Howard Gardner. Oh, mine. He is the person who wrote this Multiple Intelligence, who is known for his theory of multiple intelligences at a campus program at Harvard University, USA. Dr. Vasanthi is also an accredited tutor for Harvard University's WIDE online programs on differentiated instructions. Dr. Vasanthi has also published many papers at national and international conferences through the AIAER, CBSE's CENBOSEC, and also at CBSE National Sahodaya Conferences. For abbreviation expansion, please contact Madam. I'm sorry, don't ask me what it is. Dr. Vasanthi has received the following state level awards: the Tamil Nadu State Runner position in the Air India, the Hindu Dinamalar Bolt BOLT contest for teachers in the year 2004, Best Teacher Award by the Lions Club of Hosur Sipcot in 2004, and Lady Kalyani Sivaswamy Iyer Award for Best Teacher in the year 2010. Moving on to the national level awards, Dr. Vasanthi Thiagarajan has received the CBSE Award for Teachers in the year 2004. I think 2004 has been a lucky year for you, Akka. CBSE Mentor Award in 2013, and the National Award for Teachers in the year 2012 from the Honorable President of India on 5th September 2013. And we are now 7 years since you received that fabulous, fantastic award from the then President of India. And moving on to the International Awards, Dr. Vasanthi Thiagarajan has received the Fulbright Distinguished Award and Teaching Scholar Award from the Department of State, USA in 2011. An Outstanding Educator in Residence Award from the Ministry of Education, Government of Singapore. Oh, wow. Dr. Vasanthi Thiagarajan is involved in the following CBSE assignments: member of the telecounseling team set up by the CBSE since 2006. CBSE Master Trainer for CCE and ASL, CBSE Mentor Monitor for CCE Implementation, CBSE Coordinator for CCE Evidences of Assessment at Shishya School, which is the Nodal Center, CBSE Resource Person for SGI Training, Classroom Management, Life Skills, Gender Sensitivity, Career Guidance to CBSE Schools, the Arts Integration, Happy Classrooms, CBSE Mentor for ASL, CBSE Center Superintendent, I'm becoming breathless. Oh, Center Superintendent for AISSE, and Chief Nodal or Supervisor for AISSE Examinations Evaluations, Dr. Vasanthi Thyagarajan has undergone the following training, ASL Master Training by Cambridge University at CBSE Office, Delhi. Ma'am, my God, I think I need to raise myself and salute you. You cannot see my head now. I need to raise and then it's a standing ovation to occur for her presence here, who is going to talk to us about new national.
Thank you so much, but I think
wonderful to you. So, most of you have heard many telecast on the new national educational policy. I'm sure about it. That was in 1968. We had the Kothari Commission, who brought in the first education policy, which was again tinkered and changed in the year 1986, right? And that was the National Education Policy of 1986, which was again tinkered a little bit here and there in 1992. And almost now, it was just a small adjustments and changes in 1992. But in 2020, the new education policy was approved by the MHRD and it is there on the table for implementation. I think we must compliment Mr. Kasturi Rangan, who had spent a lot of time for almost 3-4 years. And what I like in this is, what I really appreciate and respect in this is, it is just not a few team of people who have framed this NEP 2020. It has been done almost getting 2 lakhs odd suggestions, or 2.5 lakh suggestions across the country. I believe more than 6,000 panchayats took part in suggesting what should be the new policy for India. And 36 years have surpassed. And based on the entire country's contribution, this NEP 2020 was placed on the table of the MHRD, who approved this, and today it is here with us for implementation. And before I commence my few of my doubts on this NEP 2020, I believe that this NEP 2020 has been brought in looking at the policies across the country. We want to be a country with education comparing with the global standards. And when you talk about the global standards, right, we should be the first. In fact, today we are hovering somewhere around 74-75% as far as the literacy rate is concerned, or little above that, maybe 80%. I'm not very clear about the percentage, but compared to other countries, we are far below. There are countries at 99.9, there are countries at 100%, there are countries at 90-92%, but India has to move to that 100% literacy rate. And my question is to Akka, will this new NEP, under what vision this has been formulated, and will this take us to close to 100% literacy, maybe in the next 10 to 15 years? Over to you, Akka, and let's hear Dr. Vasanthi ma'am's opinion about this. Over to you, ma'am. Thank you for you being
Thank
here
you
with
so
us.
Thank you so much. Thank you. First of all, the question on literacy and the attainment of 100% literacy is addressed in NEP by actually phasing out the structure of primary school education, middle school, with special reference to the, if you're talking about the college times, the breakup into the courses, allowing participants to get. These are a number of such branches that have come into the policy now to enable dropout rates. Because somewhere the structure of our education in the past probably has been so examination focused, it could have led to a number of students actually dropping out. Yeah, is my voice audible? Yes, voice is audible?
Yeah, it is audible, it is audible. Yeah. Please go on, carry on, ma'am.
Fine. So when it comes to literacy, the NEP has now given a kind of phase out where the early childhood education is being given, numeracy and literacy being given across there. Right, so it's not exactly on the English language, kindergarten, getting into school. It's more about getting children into the fundamentals. So when we are trying to define literacy per se, what are we trying to define? Right, is that you will learn how to write your name, calculate a few things. Who are the people you're talking about when we talk about literate learners? Are we talking about adult literate learners or to come illiterate learners coming on board? So a multi-pronged policy will have to be designed across the country. One, to take care of regular school streaming, but second most important one is where the NEP has focused on non-formal learning. So this non-formal learning is all about enabling learners to learn at their own pace, enabling rural children to get back to school, getting private schools on board to support their community. Now, if all this happens together, then a movement forward will happen in literacy. Otherwise, you know, saying with lip service that 100% literacy will happen could become very utopian. But the NEP has given a clear scope for it to happen at a multi-pronged effort and level. Does it answer your question?
Yes, ma'am, certainly. Now, Mike very clearly said, and we are talking about early childhood care and education. And yes. I believe from my understanding of quite a few reading about the little children, the brain develops by the age of eight. And now we have those 5 plus 3 plus 3 plus 4. Now we are bringing in a child at the age of three, right? And then put them into the foundational stage. You put them into pre-KG, then to LKG, then to KG, and then to first and second standard. So what I want to know from you is, you know, what, in your opinion, what are the most important areas that should be incorporated in this for ensuring the holistic development of the child? So, you know, they go with a free mind. Children, no test, nothing during the foundation. But what are the things we should put in into the curriculum of those 5 years wherein the brain gets developed by the time they reach their 8th year of their life? Over to you, Akka.
Beautiful question, because what we're looking at is under the age of 8, which is what the NEP is covering under early childhood care and education, which it calls as, you know, the ECCE. Under the age of 8, this is the most vulnerable growth period for children. And after this, probably the teenage time. So when we talk about this prior to the age of 8, in my personal opinion, I call it the critical absorption years. Why I call it critical absorption years is because though the NEP says you focus on the numeracy and the literacy aspects, fine. We also have to look at skills of communication, whether it is in the local language or in English, focus on the communication skills, because children are early learners and they can grasp very quickly. But the school will also have to look at a focus on values. Now, when I talk about values, we're not talking about abstract values, which children could get very confused about. Schools, I would say, if you look at Japan and the emulation of values in Japan, they say catch them young there. So values are not taught, they have to be caught. And how do we do that? Along with this numeracy and literacy and all that, this prior to 8, early childhood of children, that's the right time when children are observing everything around them. Everything includes the value systems. So later on, telling children to be honest, telling children to be this, to be that, doesn't make sense. So who are the people these children are now observing? They're observing adults, obviously. So who are the adults they observe? It could be an older sibling, could be parents, could be neighbors, could be the teachers when they go to school. Are we, as adults, demonstrating the right values that we want our children to have? So you talk about honesty, you give a story of some leader, you give a story. It just doesn't make sense to children anymore. They need to be demonstrable. If I'm talking about something like care of environment, at that age, 3 years, children can't understand honesty and all that. And giving them a proverb, honesty is the best policy, it doesn't work. We have to start with what they can possibly emulate. Would it be taking care of their own surroundings, keeping their places clean, not wasting their food, right? Personal hygiene. Would it be taking care of plants in their homes? They have to begin there. Because the moment children get into this conscious state that I have to go beyond myself, values around me, the child has already gone into the track of doing good. Then slowly bring in these values. Otherwise, thrusting it on them is not going to help. And that's why I feel in the early the numeracy and the literacy. Because the NEP, you know, opening short statement, like a preamble, talks very clearly about the design of a complete human being. And the complete human being is not about numeracy. It is a complete human being in terms of their values, attitudes, maybe skills. But values and attitudes. And these have to be nurtured with lot of care. You cannot have a curriculum to take children through. And teachers and parents, I believe, hold the key to that kind of a nurturing in children. That is why I feel that these are the critical absorption years. I tell my school nothing more than that. They are the critical absorption years. After 8, it could get very challenging to get children back on track. And that is why these first 8 years, they say the learning starts from the womb. It just happens after the child is born. We have enough stories in the Mahabharata and so on to tell us that learning happens in the womb. It does. So what does the child get exposed to? What kind of atmosphere is there in the home? Does everyone look happy around that child? What brings happiness? Because happiness is fundamental to all of us. It's a fundamental right of sorts. And therefore, I believe families first, schools next, will have to focus on values. Once that is done, and the child has the platform to rest oneself, and the self-awareness begins, children then slowly become accountable for what they do. Otherwise, suddenly after the age of 8 would be like grade 3 today in our schools, grade 2 or grade 3, you cannot thrust anything down children's throat. And believe me, younger children today in grades 2 or 3 or 4, you can see the immense kind of knowledge banks that they are. So they don't need the textbook anymore. You go to the Google search engine, you get enough. Child can do it, explore. Then what is it that the school has to be giving them? And I strongly believe you have to bat for that complete human being. And I'm grateful to the NEP for starting the entire document as a preamble that the immense potential, you know. It talks about education being fundamental for what? Achievement of the full human potential. What is the full human potential? It is not in terms of the academic potential alone. Human potential goes beyond that into the value systems. Because these young children are going to lead the country in the future. They have to become responsible, become self-aware, go beyond themselves, and so otherwise today children being the only ones in their family hardly know how to take care of others. They're so child-centered and you can't blame them for that. As somebody said, the school is in building. I don't know, many of my children in my webinar now, the old students said the school was our first home. Because our parents were always working. So the teachers took care of us even after us being redefined, and the NEP has come to strengthen that role. So we were to read carefully into this document, you can see the entire focus is a shift from academic to building of that human being and the potential within. And that's what the UNESCO document some years spoke about. The treasure within. What is the treasure that, what's the treasure we have within our children? And they spoke about the four pillars years, and that's what the ideal is important in early childhood education and care.
Absolutely. I think well said. I really appreciate the way you had taken on families, the first most priority for all of us. Undoubtedly, what you said is true. And I believe this NEP is going to reduce the burden of heavy bags being carried by our children. You know, in the sense that even the foundation stages, you know, like the first five, I think children go without bags. I mean, this is, they enjoy going and being in the school with no bags. Otherwise, you find today little children carrying those heavy bags with weight of books more than their total weight. So I believe that, I want to talk to you about how would you like to implement those 10 days bagless period for students in grade 6 to 8, where they will get attached to a local craftspersons or a local tradesperson. So how do you like to implement that, ma'am?
Yes.
That 10 days of bagless period.
Fantastic proposal, no doubt.
Okay.
Please go ahead, complete your question, then I'll answer. Sorry.
Yeah. How does it work, that 10 days bagless? Is it mean that the first out of 30 days, 10 days they go without bags, and balance the 20 days they go with bags? How do you explain this?
Krish, that's not how we interpret that. If you look at the weekdays, we work for about 5 days a week. Some schools work for 5 days and half of Saturdays. And if you look at 45 periods a week, doesn't matter whether you work 8 periods a day and 5 on a Saturday, or 9 periods a day into 5 days with Saturday, Sundays off. Let's take a total of 45 periods of the day, of the week, sorry. Let's take one bagless day in a week, making it 4 bagless days, and you double it up. Nothing is going to happen to the curriculum. Of the arts with focus on the, we'll have to look at how subjects get integrated into the arts. Now, for my as a practitioner, what I am doing, see, we interact a lot with the local arts people. And children across the school meet this potter. He brings the clay. They work with him, and we have pottery. We bring the basket weavers from nearby. Give them livelihood, they bring all their cane, sit with the children. Prepare. We have very tiny table mats. So we have to revive the local. Actually, a day without your books, that's it. It's not one day without academic, right? So what can you do in one day without a bag, 2 days without back. Go for enable children to do collaborative work that day, right? Let's do presentations, artwork, the arts, craft, dance, music. In of main subjects, right? Look into a lot of explorative learning which doesn't require a bag. Cannot children come now and do technology-based research in the school, then work with the team on it? Why should they have a bag? They're getting so obsessed with that heavy bag that they're carrying, we get perturbed. I don't see anything. It really has to be interpreted. Let children do. You have beautiful Atal labs today. You have robotics labs, correct?
Yes.
There are so many. You remember R.K. Narayan gave his famous cartoon before the parliament once about the child carrying that bag. It kind of turned around the thinking in the country about this heavy bag. And I think a lot of pediatricians across responded by saying, yes, it's high time this bag load was reduced. Children carry what they need. They carry what they don't need. They simply carry everything to school. And in the process, that very delicate spinal cord of the child is getting badly damaged for life. They don't realize that. So I think bagless days must be encouraged. What are we getting perturbed about? It can happen. It can work. We just need to redesign the way the classes need to happen, Krish. It can happen.
Absolutely. Thanks a lot, ma'am. Now, my next clarification is, what are your ideas on how to identify gifted children in your school? And how to nurture their talent so that they're able to fast track their learning process in accordance with their capabilities, which which happens today, but not to the extent what it should happen, because every school must have some yardsticks of finding out the real true talent of a particular child and build it so that their dreams comes true. Like, for example, imagine Sachin Tendulkar becoming a doctor, right? So I becoming an engineer. So, you know, how do you identify the talents and how do you fast track those talents in accordance with their capabilities? Over to you, ma'am.
So basically,
ma'am, I think your voice is breaking. Your voice is breaking.
Yeah, is it clear now?
Yeah, now it is clear.
Are you able to get me now?
Yeah, it is clear now.
Is my voice clear now?
Could you continue talking, ma'am? I mean,
yeah, I'll disturb you if it is not clear. Is my voice audible?
Yeah, it is audible. It's audible.
Yeah, it is
audible.
When we look at our children in a classroom, it's very difficult to identify who is going to have mixed ability children in the class. Differentiated instruction has come. We have to look at the category of the gifted, which is a long neglected category, the gifted. I agree that inclusive education has come to stay. We take care of the average children adequately, and the ones who are really supporting them with special educators. But if you look at this category at the top, the gifted, somewhere along the line, we just allow them to float. It's high time the school now reorganized itself to look at that category also, because this is the group that's going to contribute to the thinking of the country in the future. It doesn't mean the others can't. What I'm trying to say is the gifted must be recognized, right? And it's not your academic tests alone that is going to recognize them. Because when we talk about gifted, what gifted are we talking about? Are we talking about their competence in terms of their learning? How gifted? For that, you cannot isolate a challenged learner. Today, the classes have become inclusive. What we do is normally we try and give multiple learning multi-level learning. Take the first level, which everyone can do. Very high order thinking, which a few can us to access. And this helps because the challenged areas that the gifted children need can be provided through this multi-level and if we were to compare the United States, children who are pulled out by the districts who are excessively good in their academics are put into gifted schools, because that's where the Nobel Prize winners are born. But we need to nurture the gifted children. It doesn't mean higher or creative thinking. The children who have that unique potential for critical thinking, problem solving. If these are the, is what I call talented, not 100 out of 100 mark. I don't believe that. We have to work on that for sure. But the NEP has given provision that gifted students, schools must make provision to take care of the gifted. Otherwise, they would become a neglected lot. No doubt about that. Thank you.
Wonderful. I would like to ask one question more to you before we wind up the session. Nothing happens unless the teachers change themselves, because they need to prepare for the new educational policy. And in your opinion, out of 100 teachers, how many teachers would change? I mean, they are forced to change if they want to remain in the profession. And if they accept those changes, right, could you kindly add a note on the new focus on teacher education? I understand that the future is going to be 4 years of BEd. I mean, it used to be 1 year of BEd. The BEd used to be on, BEd used to be on distance learning, right? And it went up to 2 years now. Yes. And the new policy says the BEd is going to be for 4 years. So it's all fine. But, with your experience and exposure into the field of education, what are the areas of new focus, the teacher education, for a continuous professional development of our teachers? Because teachers cannot be teaching what they learned to the 8th standard, what they learned in 8th standard, because things are changing at a faster pace today. And madam, what do you think are those areas of focus as far as the teacher education is concerned? And what are those continuous professional development that need to be hammered into our teachers to implement this educational policy? Over to you, ma'am.
Thing is that the NEP has clearly defined, very clear question.
Yeah.
Has linked the role of CPD for teachers and how important it is for schools. Is then the skill track of every teacher will be different.
I know.
Right. So when the school makes its annual pedagogical plan, which teacher needs what?
Your voice
is breaking. So the NEP has brought up certain areas.
Your voice is breaking.
Breaking now?
Yeah, continue. Let me see now. It was breaking. Yeah, I think maybe your net is a bit slow, but otherwise, now it's okay. I'm audible. It's audible. But when you continuously speak, it is breaking sometimes. Over to you, ma'am. Please carry on.
Probably, yes.
Yeah,
so
now
what I'm looking at is we'll need to make sure the teachers, where every teacher will have to be individually marked. For example, you will have a different, the ones who finish 5 years, another one. The ones who come right out of the BEd college will have another track. So what do schools do? We are lucky in the CBSE schools, I would say, that the board takes a lot of responsibility of this CPD. If you look at the COVID times, innumerable programs have been actually given out for teachers free of cost and today very nominal. It is up to teachers to choose that huge menu card. But schools and principal especially, the main stakeholder in that school will have to decide which one is for whom. The NEP specifically talks about the 21st century skills, and these are the three areas that have every teacher on board. Because if you do not integrate the experiential learning into the learning process, then the entire stuff, no longer then is it lesson learning or all the mundane stuff. You'll have to read the NEP for teachers. We've got to take advantage of that and go along. It's absolutely essential. Every teacher must have a clear CPD. I don't know how much of my voice
is breaking. Voice is really breaking.
Reached out to you. But I think I'm done with my answer.
Absolutely, you're done with your answer. We could grade it. We will attach all those words and make
sir,
a sentence.
No issues.
Absolutely.
Sure.
Ma'am, I would like you to comment on my last clarification. My takeaways from the new educational policy is the government is going to spend about 6% of the GDP on education, which was earlier 3%, and the introduction of vocational training for the students from 6th standard. Good salute. And the results, unlike, the progress report, is going to be a 360 degree, right? The peers, the teachers, self-assessments, fantastic. One thing which I want to just talk to you about is that the new educational policy is going to instill the maximum fees based on the category of a school, that they cannot overcharge, that it's like an MRP on a product, the maximum retail price. So if that is being implemented, How those fees controlled by the government is going to impact on certain schools, ma'am? Like, for example, you can't overcharge. Like, a particular school can charge 10,000 rupees a month for as fees from students. So now they may be charging 13,000 or 14,000 based on the facilities, availability of infrastructure, that, this, that. But once the ruling comes from the government that this is the maximum that you can charge, what would be the takeaway from you, ma'am? What do you think about this fixation of a fees by the government and controlling the fees by the government in terms of the fees from the schools? Over to you, Akka. This would be my final question to you.
Yeah. This is a very varies from, but what I can add on.
Yeah, it is cutting. Ma'am, it is totally breaking.
Here?
No, it's totally breaking. It's totally breaking.
Able to hear me now?
Yeah, yes.
Yeah, I just changed my connection. Is it clear now?
Yeah, it's clear now, ma'am.
Much better?
Oh, far better.
Okay. So the question that you asked about the fees, you know, basically, I think this entire situation about control of fee has come probably because many schools have overcharged without providing adequate facilities.
Okay.
Now everybody has been blacklisted in the same brush, and if the at least Tamil Nadu government, we are asked to present before them the fees charged versus the facility, and the clearance is given to us. So nobody is barring what you charge. If there's a ceiling, then schools will have to definitely go transparent and request for a revision to support, because on the one hand, the CBSE says we have to pay them 6th pay scale, 7th pay scale, and so on. And on the other hand, it says you charge only so much. Then where does the money come from? Isn't it? So that kind of talk, it has to happen across the table, and that too by people who can represent the management part of it.
Absolutely.
And if that happens, I don't think, because teacher salary is a big priority today.
Absolutely.
You cut down the fee, then it will first affect the salary you're going to pay your teachers.
Yes, very true.
So you'll have to look at both. And also, some schools charge 1 lakh, 2 lakhs and whatever. And that's where I think the whole thing starts, where are you providing adequate facilities for the children to charge that kind of fee? And if that transparency is brought in the way we present what we are taking, I do not anticipate too much of an issue. If schools can show that these are my teachers, this is the number I have, and this is the reason why I charge this fees, I don't anticipate a problem about fee fixation at all.
Ma'am, 9th, 10th, 11th and 12th, I was made to understand that the students can choose, right? They can choose, like humanities, like history, then you can do mathematics, then you can go to biology. So you can choose whatever subject of your choice. I mean, this is a good move. And finally decide on what he or she wants to be in the future. Well done. But which means, like, for example, the schools need to equip themselves with many number of teachers, right? Today, the students pick based on the subjects available in a particular school. But true. Let's say you have 30 such different subjects, and you have 30 different students, and all the 30 different students keep choosing different subjects. Won't it be difficult for a school to have all those teachers to teach maybe one student on geography, one student on economics, one student on history? So how do we manage when you try to implement this in the future? What is your takeaway from this? We need more teachers.
Yeah, I don't think the NEP is forcing a school to offer a vague platter to the children, sir.
Apri, no. Okay, fine.
As far as skill subjects are concerned, you may. And there the CBSE has given us the lenience of outsourcing experts from industry also.
All right, so that would
be. I have, let's say, 40 children, 5 want to do carpentry, 5 want to do that as a skill subject. I can ask people to come 1 hour a week and 2 hours a week and take the class. Similar to that, the number of subjects I'm willing to offer depends on the number of teachers I can access.
Okay.
For example, in Hosur, if I do not have teachers of that background in so many numbers, I probably will not offer so many subjects on my platter. I don't need to.
All right. So it's very clear. So My other teacher friends, you have any question? One question, if one of you can put across to.
Nice, because I'm the only one speaking, and they're all.
Teachers can put one
on the stage with me here.
Any clarification required from ma'am? You can always ask.
Clarification in a discussion would be wonderful.
this is a golden opportunity. Please don't miss it.
You were saying about
the
subject. Yes, I'm here.
Yeah, please, ma'am.
Regarding the subject, the child can offer physics or commerce like that. But in our country, like India, if their child is choosing physics, but he cannot take up any other subject if he's going with the commerce, because they got ancillaries like chemistry and maths. So how this will help the children? Unless if they are going in particular subject, it will be easier. If not, will it be difficult for the children to take a particular stream, ma'am?
Yes, that's a very good question you asked, because the NEP may tell us let children take any kind of combination that they want. Probably children will jump at it, you know, and say, I'll take physics, then I'll take maybe drawing and all that. But then the ground reality is that in their the NTA based exams, would they permit a child to take this combination? The CBSE has not given total clarity. Yes, NEP has released its document. CBSE will have to now streamline that document and make it applicable for schools. So though we have talked about 9, 10 and 11 and all those exams, right now we are still running in a school with 12th standard. So when the phase out is going to happen, when this 9, 10, 11 is going to come into, they say 21, 22 should happen. Until and unless we are given total orientation on how to take the children into that category, what is their future? It's not stopping with 11th standard. What happens after 11th? What about the careers that they're going to map and take forth? If that is not outlined clearly by the CBSE also, then I think it will be very confusing for schools and for parents, more importantly. Right now in schools, we are all playing safe because we have a 12th standard going, we have a 11th standard going, we are happy. But till CBSE steps in, and they have already released documents about that, but the clarity and the orientation of principals to now shift the school over into a, you know, 11 stage, 8 and then 9, 10, 11 as one category, that has not yet happened. Once it is done, the pattern of exam in class 11, even that is going to be taken over by the NTA. That's what the NEP says. The 11th exam will also be conducted by the NTA. So we will need that clarity. It's not yet come through very sharply for us. We need to wait.
Thank you, ma'am.
Ma'am, one more doubt I have. Regarding the additional subject, ma'am, skilled subject, we are asking the 9th standard onwards, and now it started from middle school also.
Yes.
If the child has secured a compartment, we are asking the other subject can be considered for promotion.
Yes.
So now the parents are asking, if when you are considering for compartment, you are considering this, why not the total? For the highest, for example, if a child scores more mark in any of the 5 subject, can we consider that as a total, highest total?
No, what the CBSE is trying to tell us is the idea behind the 6th subject being taken by students, it's not mandatory yet. It is only optional, even now.
Yes.
What 6, 7, 8, they say it's good to introduce it right now, and your application only goes up to CBSE level. But 9 and 10 will have to go to the affiliation portal and actually formally log in there and introduce the subject, because that child will have to write an examination based on that 6th subject also. The idea is to give a buffer to the child that they can take the best of 5 and pass the examination. That is the purpose behind the 6th subject. Right. So if the parent has taken the trouble of, in grade 10, let us say the child has done, we have only that English second language, and then we have sciences and social science, and then you have the fifth subject, right? Mathematics. And even in math now, they're broken up into basic and higher level math.
Yeah.
So when that has happened, and the 6th subject is coming in, let us say the child failed in mathematics. So it's very obvious that they cannot get into an engineering stream till they cleared that mathematics. But they can get into a stream which does not require math and can be declared as passed with the 5 subjects that they passed in out of the 6. And the child can take a compartment in math, and assuming they do well in that, then if they wish to apply and the school wishes to consider them, then yes. The 6th subject is a buffer to support pass for a child, not failure, to support the pass system.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
What about board exams for 8th and 5th and all that they were talking about?
It's not going to be defined. Because, you know, that's going to be a mammoth exercise of examination if it happens. But there would be levels which the CBSE will shortly unfold. At grade 3, what's going to happen? Yes, because these are all transitional years for children. Moving, we all know that as principals, the curriculum changes after 3 when they enter 4 and 5. It totally changes when they enter 6 when the physics chemistry comes in instead of general science.
Yeah.
Right? So when that's happening, these could be outcome-based examinations which must happen to clear children to get ready for that area. It's not that it's some kind of a danger looming in the corner.
Yeah,
no,
that's right.
It is a clearance that has to happen in grade 3 to go to grade 4 and in grade 5 in order to go to 6, in grade 8 in order to go to grade 9. Otherwise, children could be carrying gaps of learning till 12th standard and may not be aware of it throughout their lives.
Correct.
So at grade 3, you have this block. It helps the school to kind of put on, you know, same power all the children during that exam before they come to the 4th level.
Analyze
your school results and make sure that you redo it in order to get them ready for. We do bridge courses now, don't we?
Yeah, we do that.
So why do we do that? We have an examination and then a bridge course. Instead of that, we'll be revisiting learning outcomes of grade 1 to 3 to ensure, not even 1 to 3, even 3 years plus to that 3rd standard level to ensure that all of that the children are mastered. Otherwise, they are lost. They come to grade 10 and ask, what is a mixed fraction? You're in big trouble.
Correct.
You see,
Shankar,
they don't know what question from you.
Yeah. Thank you.
Shankar sir, Priya madam, any questions from your end? Krishnan Kumari madam, any questions from your end? Where are you, Shankar sir? Shankar Narayan sir, are you there? Or?
No, sir.
Right. Priya madam. All right. So, Swamiji, are you there? Swamiji, are you there?
Yes, he's there.
Swamiji, if no questions, you have any questions, Swamiji, on the national new educational policy?
Yeah, I just wanted to ask one question. Ma'am was talking about the values part.
Yes.
And you are saying that this national education policy will certainly imbibe the values and Indian culture.
Definitely.
See, how do we make sure, or how can we make sure that it is exactly implemented at the school level? And what is the way in which we ensure, the government ensure that the values are exactly imparted to the students?
Yes, sir. When we talk about values, as I mentioned in my talk earlier, you can't have a complete list of values which you think children should imbibe at the flicker of a hand. It doesn't happen like that. So this values that we want our children to have, they need to be very clearly defined as to which ones come first and which come later. So there are abstract values which cannot be imbibed in younger years. Those values will be reserved for later, where the self-awareness and understanding of children is broader. But at the tender years, as I mentioned, schools will definitely have to design guidelines where these values are imbibed into the learning itself of their major lessons. If it comes to mathematics, what of mathematics has values to show children? Correct?
Yeah.
What literature will show values? How do people respond to situations in literature stories? So the teacher will have to very carefully weave her values around that. And you can't have simply one framework and say this has to be executed with lesson plans. It doesn't happen as simply as that. And as I told you, any kind of value education, any kind of curriculum will not work if teachers do not walk the talk. Parents do not walk the talk. Society does not walk the talk. But what are our children seeing today? That the ones who have money wield the most influence.
Correct.
And might, they say, is right. That's what they see on movies.
Yes.
Anyone
who's
a tough guy appears to be right. He gets away with whatever he wants to do. Right? So, that media is a very strong influence that is going to batter our basic values. But our country, And I think Amrita, you know far better than me, sir. You have also driven values as part of your curriculum. You're not working on your textbooks at all. I think values and the foundation of values is what your entire educational system is focusing on. And then the whole human being, and then your engineering or your high school or whatever. So what is happening there? It's not prayer, maybe meditation, mindful meditation, acts of kindness, taking care of environment. All this will have to be designed in such a way that seamlessly the child, the parent, the teacher, adults and children, hand in hand, they take the values across, sir. It can't be that you do it and I will do nothing. You be honest. It doesn't matter if I tell lies. I'm an adult. I can do what I like. No. If I say you cannot have fast foods, then I should not be having fast foods.
Yeah, ma'am. Yeah, I just want the role modeling of the parent,
if it happens, and along with role modeling of teachers, and there's a blended, beautiful value system that the school is going to design, which is practical, and the children can imbibe through looking at role models around them. Values can be caught, sir. They cannot be taught. No.
No, ma'am. I just wanted to point out one fact that when myself and Krish visited your school, we were unable to locate you. Then Priya told that you are along with the students and you are walking.
Yes.
So that what I'm saying is how far is it possible that, see, ultimately it is in the hands of teachers.
True.
So that part is more important when we say that there is a policy, but ultimately the implementation has to be more effective.
Yes.
Yeah, that is all what I wanted to point out.
Sir, you're absolutely right, because I believe values are always top down, sir.
Yes.
Integrity, yes, truthfulness, honesty, everything is top down. So if you're talking about me being with my children in the ground, going for a walk in the morning, I use the time for a healthy walk with all my kids and enjoy the vitamin D of the sunshine. We take a long walk of 15 minutes. I have all these kids clinging on to me. It's very informal. And we just talk about everything and anything under the sun there.
Yeah.
So they ask me, what did you have for breakfast? And I ask them what you did, what happened at home yesterday. It's such a beautiful informal thing. So when that ice is broken between the teacher and the child, the rest of it will flow well. And exactly. We have to demonstrate values, sir.
Because
children are looking at us all the time. There's no if and but about it. Absolutely.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much.
So, thank you so much. It's time for us to wind. That begins well, have to end well. And a big applause and big clap for ma'am and Swamiji for the final
program. One thing.
You have time.
Doctorate, but not in Harvard. I've done my doctorate through the Alagappa University, but in Harvard, I've gone there to do the multiple intelligences program, which Dr. Gardner was doing for us. And it was a great experience working with him, his humility. And I used to have a lot of discussions within. The biggest thing I learned in the United States was the humility of great men there. And my stint, which you mentioned at the Fulbright Scholarship, was at the University of Maryland, which is one of the premium universities in America. There also 4 months, I have rubbed shoulders with the best of educationists whom we are talking about today, right? Nobel laureates who walk the corridors. But you look at them, they're so humble, they're so approachable, and they talk to you like, you know, they're learning from you. And Dr. Gardner, I spent hours and hours with him in Harvard after the regular seminar. He would ask me to come and discuss multiple intelligences with him. He was so fascinated that somebody in India was interested in. And so I used to go spend my time with him, talk about MI, and you won't believe in his recent release of his the multiple intelligence visited. He had the goodness to mention my name there in my discussions with him. So you look at the humility of the man we're talking about. And he sent me a copy of the book saying that, Vasanthi Thyagarajan, I've used your name in my book on multiple intelligences. Here you are, take a look at it. Because I told him that when he was exploring the 10th intelligence, why don't you look into the Ravana aspect of 10 heads? Probably that would account for the 10th intelligence. Explore. So he mentioned that, saying, Vasanthi Thyagarajan says we need to explore Ravana and the 10th intelligence. That is the humility of great people I've seen, Krish. And if we can take a leaf out of that, I think that's a great way forward for all of us.
Akka, we are seeing that in you, no doubt about it. And as you rightly mentioned, you would have done the PhD, your research from Alagappa University, not from Harvard University. But I'm sure you having done your PhD from Alagappa University, it is not too far that Alagappa University also will be a Harvard University in the future. I think that would be all our prayers. And we have many such universities coming up as per the new educational policy, because any international university top 50, top 100 would come into India. So everything that begins well have to end well. And I'm thankful to Swamiji for his patient hearing and his presence here in the entire 2 hours of our deliberations today. And especially those teachers who have been viewing us, right? And of course, Vasanthi ma'am needs a special
thank you.
Applause from all of us. Thank you so much for sharing your knowledge and intelligence. And thankful to Dr. Shankar Narayanan, who came in between on four wheels. Yes. Thankful to him for that. Dr. Priya ma'am, right? Priya Sridhar, Sujata ma'am, Subbalakshmi ma'am, then Nitya ma'am, as well as Krishna Kumari ma'am for being present. And you know, I mean, let me all Akka, let me tell you, all these teachers, you know, when we just invited them for this particular, no one ever said let me think. No, definitely. I think every teacher said we are there for you. And in fact, that's a great honor for us that definitely all the teachers from the field of education is with Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham. And thank you so much, ma'am. As you, one thing which I want to underline, that yes, the values that learn from Shishya, right? It is easy for us when they join our institutions. Values from all your schools, because ma'am mentioned, I was just mentioning it. It's easy for them to, it is easy for us to inculcate. No new values are required because they already learn from the schools. So in fact, we are more thankful to all the schools for producing such excellent students.
Thank you.
I don't think Swami has any, or me have any problem of teaching value, because they come with those values. Isn't it? So I think Swami and me should give all our teachers and principals a special clap for developing those values and bringing those students to our campuses.
But
so
what
thank
is
you.
I think, Krish, is that in the college level, you are strengthening those values, which
absolutely
they could lose very easily. And Amrita is strengthening it, not allowing them to lose it.
Absolutely.
That is important.
We are trying our best.
Swamiji needs a special mention for driving that across.
Swamiji, a special clap to Swamiji. And as you rightly said, Akka, that it's difficult for us even to maintain when they grow up beyond, you know, 18 years or 19 years, because they are physically, they change, mentally, they change. It's not like school students when they come to a professional college. And person like Swamiji, you know, he's able to maintain that value system among all our children. So with this good, sweet words, it's time for us to wind up. Thank you all for being with us.
Thank you. I know many of you
are feeling very hungry.
No, not yet.
Not at all. So thank you once again. Our salute from Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham, and a special thanks again from all of us. So this is Medhul Krish signing off from Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham.
Thank
you. And stay safe. Stay secure.
Thank you for the opportunity.
Meet again.
Thanks, Swamiji. Thank you.
Sir, my special thanks to Janani also, sir.
Thank you very much. Thank you. 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 Th
Thank you. Bye. See you all.